Markets gave investors quite a roller coaster ride these past few weeks, with the Dow tanking or rallying several hundred points on any given day. While the action caused investor sentiment to drop sharply, not all stocks have performed poorly. For instance, take Johnson & Johnson. Oh, by the way, that happens to be the stock that Marco has asked about. So let's take a look. So, should investors buy J&J stock in the future? And if so, how much should they pay for it? When the stock market begins to crack, there are a few places to hide. However, some stocks do better than others. J&J is in that category, partly due to the consistency it has demonstrated in the past. For 56 consecutive years, it has not missed a dividend payment, and during that time, it has raised the dividend. Since J&J's payout ratio now stands below 50%, this streak will likely continue for many years to come. It does help that J&J has a stellar balance sheet and a business model that holds well in good times and in bad. During recessions, some consumers may switch to generics, but by and large, J&J is well insulated against economic declines. Over the last few quarters, investors have not been very concerned about the economy. Thus, growth stocks have been favored over continuous winners like J&J. But with the yield curve inverting, many investors are worrying about a possible recession on the horizon. As a result, traditional defensive stocks such as J&J and others are rebounding. But nothing is worse than piling into a name like J&J only to see those stocks retreat as investors rotate back into the beaten-down growth stocks. So, is the positive momentum of J&J stock likely to continue? Let's take a look at the charts. We're looking at the 20-year monthly chart on Johnson & Johnson, and the symbol is J&J. For disclosure purposes, I do not own any J&J at this time. Looking at the chart, we can see that in mid-2018 was the low, and then the high here we're reaching at new record levels currently. The previous high was at this point here, but you go all the way back into the year 2000, you have that low there, and had a relatively good climb all the way up into 2008, and then down at the bottom of the great financial crisis here in early 2009. But since then, it went on a meandering route here for the first few years. But since mid-2012, it's been on a pretty good run. We've had some lows here, here, and then, of course, here in 2018 again. But for the most part, it's had a pretty good climb with a stair-step structure toward the latter few years. Moving into the MACD, we can see that we had a bottom here. We're moving on up. I think we just moved through the slow line, the fast line moved through the slow line. I think we have more room to run. But let's go ahead and take a look and see if we have any other indications. Here in the histogram also shows the bottom and then the increase there. No sign of stopping there. And neither in the price rated change. The relative strength index is at 70.91, which is relatively healthy. We'll probably start doing some sawtoothing as we did in this time frame here and perhaps during these time frames here. So I would imagine that this can stay elevated for another few months, as long as a year at least, as long as things remain well in the company itself, and I think that they will. Stochastics looks good. They're on their way up. And volume looks fine. And the Williams looks like the other oscillators. We're in this upper territory here, but we can do some sawtoothing and stay in that upper elevated area as we did here in these previous times. For an extended period, we could do that. So moving on up. Now, the question becomes, would this be the time to buy or would it be the time to sell? And frankly, it's almost neither. You don't want to sell because I think we do have further move in the upside here in the near future. And so I wouldn't sell, but I don't know if I would buy at this point either, given that we do have a history of some movement in a wave structure here through here. We're heading on up. There's a possibility of a top and then another move down, but I don't see that yet. So I'm not quite convinced that I would buy here. And I certainly wouldn't sell because I do think there's more upside. And if you own it, I would continue to hold it. But let's go to the weekly chart and see if that shows us anything more. We're now looking at the 5-year weekly chart on Johnson & Johnson. And as you can see, it has a pretty good wave structure going. It's not all that predictable, but it's relatively decent. Moving on through here, it tends to do this in a stair step sort of manner, reaching down and then moving on up. And then coming on down and then moving on up again. And each time it reaches a new high. And that's where I think we're going right now. In the retracement, it retraces back to, I would say, a third to a half of the previous level. So this retracement here was down to that point there. This retracement here was back to this level here. So somewhere between one third and one half if you go back in time. So at this point, I'm not sure if I would buy here. I think I would wait for a consolidation, but if you own it, I would continue to hold. I wouldn't sell. And if you're in for the long term, this is definitely a stock, as you've seen, that will continue to march upward. I think it's proven that in the stock price as well as in the dividends. And moving on down here, it looks like the MACD is starting to get up to this elevated level here, such as we've seen before, and there, and then here, and then all the way back to here. So at these elevated levels, I think I'd just wait and see before I purchased any stock. The oscillators are pretty much telling us much the same. You can see price rate of change. The fast line is already heading down there. And relative strength is weakening. The stochastic is also weakening, showing us the possibility of a topping process. So, same thing here in the Williams. Back up to the price chart. I think I would wait to see if there's any consolidation. You're not going to need to be in any hurry to buy this thing. It's a proven stock. So, I would wait for a consolidation, just a penny pinch. And pick it up at that, say, one third to one half consolidation of the prior move. Otherwise, I would hold it and continue on in a long-term basis, and this will be a good stock, a good winner for your portfolio. So for today, that's ChewDog Charts. Thank you.